Welcome back. Perhaps after Amitabh Bachchan, in India, it is Usain Bolt who's made running sexy, isn't it? Everybody wants to run like Bolt. But that's the hook, isn't it? He's run 100 meters, and you're going to get these kids, Rajiv, to run 4 kilometers. So who are these kids who are going to be running this distance, and how do you think it's going to motivate them?
So we've got the junior and the senior category. The junior is 7th and 8th standard, and senior is 9th and 10th. So you've got the gender split also, male and female, boys and girls rather. And the hook is that they get to meet Usain Bolt. The winners, the fastest team, travels to wherever Usain Bolt is, and they get to meet him. So
unfortunately,
you're no longer 15, so you can't get there.
Yeah.
Perhaps
uniform,
because of your association, your association with Kuma could get you there. Yeah. You know,
we need a chaperone.
Yeah, the motivator.
But you think they've made guys like Usain Bolt have really made running smart? Or you would also want to talk about some of the middle distance runners and the others?
But I really think we need to make heroes out of people like him. Mm. I think if you make heroes like that, like we've got Usain Bolt and we have so many people looking up. It's the heroes you make is what you will have the younger people follow. I really think so. So we do have a very big Indian cinema, you know, the Hindi film industry, which is such a big sort of aspiring kind of, you know, image. Mm. I mean, you have a lot of heroes. And that's who I think almost half the kids want to be. So I think we need to build more heroes out of people like him, out of people like Usain Bolt, and that's when you will have people wanting to be them.
Even in your fraternity, you know? Or even in the Hindi film fraternity, or even in the film fraternity overall,
yeah.
You know,
yeah.
They
yeah.
have a lot of, fitness has become a very
it's such
big
a,
mantra.
So yeah,
isn't it?
I mean, actually, you see so many of these, gymnasiums, health clubs everywhere is springing up, and I think it has a lot to do with this whole culture which is coming in. But I think this initiative particularly is very, very good because it's not just talking about going to a gym and looking good. It's about making fitness part of your life. And it starts young. It starts at the grassroots level where it is, it's not just about running and having fun. It's also about a sense of competitive spirit that comes in, which is very important, you know, and it's good. It's that kind of spirit. It's a good thing for kids to have that.
You know, are you trying to tell the message coming across from Puma now is that we are not just good-looking shoes, but we are also very good shoes, isn't it?
Exactly.
Yeah.
I mean, we are serious running shoes as well.
And this focus on performance running, you think it's going to work? It's like a long-term thing for Puma and the focus on grassroots. Again, I'm coming back. You know,
yeah.
Why choose running? You know, you could have chosen multiple sports. You could have chosen different arenas. But why running again?
So, you know, if you look back at Puma's history, we had Maradona and Pele, one of the two most successful footballers who wore Puma. And then if you look at athletics, we had Linford Christie and we had some of the fastest US guys wore Puma way back. So in history, we do have that credibility in running. And just to bring it back into perspective, running is easiest for kids to do. You don't really need an equipment. You don't really need a big ground. You don't need need the infrastructure.
You need good shoes.
Yeah, you need good shoes. Exactly.
Right.
So I think that's how we thought that, you know, running is something that Puma can do and has been doing. It's just that in India, we haven't focused on it. So with the great kind of fast series that we have, I said that we can cater to these kids as well.
No, but these are for professional runners, or you also have a line for kids, the target segment or the group that you're targeting or aiming to bring on in terms of the school of speed.
Right.
That age group also can go walk into a Puma store and pick up stuff which they feel which will help them run better.
Definitely. We do have a range, you know, for everyone. It's not only for the professional athlete. It's also for amateurs and people who are just taking up running. So we have a whole gamut of running shoes now.
No, because this is not just an MD talking. It's somebody who runs and who's also a father. So obviously, when you're making an investment,
exactly.
You would want to make an investment in a product which is not going to harm you, isn't it? A lot of people go in and look at a fancy pair of shoes. The kid says, "I want this," but you say no because it's your kid who's going to wear them, and it should do more, you know, good to you rather than harm, isn't it?
But I think it's extremely important that technology, how it's coming into equipment now, I mean, especially sportswear, it's made such a huge difference in performances, you know, wherever across the board you see anything that you know, technology is extremely important. So yeah, I think you should definitely invest in a pair of shoes which will enhance your experience and also improve your performance. It's whether it's golf, it's anything everywhere, sports. The kind of science and R&D that's coming in, it just improves your performance.
Aren't you still, you look at the mindset of a youngster, you want to wear shoes not just because they're good for your feet.
Exactly.
But they also, you can wear them, you see.
Sure. I mean, yeah, that's why even our performance shoes look good.
Right. So, how many entries are you expecting? Has the initial response been very encouraging?
Initial response has been really good.
And have you called back your school?
Yes, I did. I was actually incidentally at a school reunion when we had an ad and we had the thought. So yeah, so hopefully we'll have at least 300 teams participating across three cities. This is Bombay, Delhi and Bangalore. So we would like to get more than 300 for sure. So that's our benchmark. If you realize that you were first initially competing in the city, which is common for all the school kids in any city to do. You'll have inter-school. But at a national level, when you're competing, you may be the fastest in Bombay, but you will be pitted against Delhi guys or the Bangalore guys. And then we'll definitely find the fastest in the country. So that's a challenge and that's a competitive spirit as well.
In your case, you're not you don't run for time. You run because you want to see whether you can endure it physically. Yeah. But in this case, it's going to be tough, isn't it? Yeah. Four kids, they're going to run a kilometer each. Yeah. So 4 kilometers in limited time.
Yeah. I think, is this the first time this is being done on a school level in
yes,
India?
Yes, that's the first time.
This has never happened before.
Never happened before.
On a school level, national has never happened.
No. The AIFF, the AFI, Athletic Federation of India, would be doing the junior nationals and the senior nationals, but that's not 1 kilometer, and that doesn't happen. Doesn't happen at 7th, 8th, 9th level.
At that age group. Not junior, sub junior.
The initiative of the format is what makes it very interesting, yes. Isn't it? You've got to run like a team. Because you have to run 500 meters up and back, maybe 2.5 circles of a track, depending upon the venue. Yeah. But the fact is, you can't let your teammate down. You slow down, the other person slows down. Or you run too hard, you run the first 600 too hard, the balance 400 you lose out. So they have to prepare as a team too. So it is also bringing in other values.
Exactly.
Not just working with yourself.
I think it's a great initiative, really. And not just because it's Puma, it could be anything. But I really think it's a
So are you going to keep
start.
It at three cities?
We want to take it to a lot many more cities. We are seeing how the initial response is and how this edition goes. And definitely for the second edition, we want to take it to a lot more cities.
Right. Another question I think a lot of the parents and a lot of the kids would want to know. What's in it for me? In the sense, all right, we win. So what do we get? Usain Bolt toh door ki baat hai. First place when we win, what happens?
You definitely get a lot of Puma merchandise, a lot of great stuff. You'll get a free access to any of the Puma stores. You can go pick up Puma stuff and feel good about it, yeah.
But that's only for the winners. The participants, you will have to beat your opponents to get something out there. Otherwise, you've gone out there and run. You've run with your teammates and you've run 4 kilometers.
Yes, and you also have some good-looking legs in the bargain. You might just show off those legs in the pool. You get to do that, yeah.
Right, the question, you've done the School of Speed. What else is Puma doing if the focus is going to be running?
You know, like Girish said, that if parents take it up themselves and lead by example, running becomes a lot cooler and a lot easier for the kids. So in that space, we've targeted the corporates. And in the corporate space, we're doing a similar format, but 5 kilometers. So it's a relay of 4 into 5. Each teammate runs 5 kilometers and you have a team of 4. So you can register as a company. So again, it promotes bonding outside of work. It also gets people off their chair and become a lot fitter. And because it's a corporate initiative, the HR and the company pushes you. So it's not your own doing and it's easy because it's 5 kilometers. And 5 kilometers as an adult, it's very easy for you to do it.
So is this the one that's called Urban Stampede?
Exactly. Yeah. So I was coming to it, the Puma Urban Stampede, 8 cities this year. And we hope to have at least 500 teams participating in each city. So,
and when to when? What are the timelines when you're planning to organize?
So it's starting in February. So Bombay is going to be 2nd of Feb. Delhi is going to be 16th of Feb. And then as and when the calendar goes ahead, we'll do 8 cities across the year. And then culminate again in Bombay with a finale towards the end of the year.
The advantage with the Urban Stampede is these are the guys who will actually then do a half marathon and then do a full marathon. That's where the addiction sets in, and you know, you get into a lot of running groups and associated activities which sort of fuels the thing after that. So they start off with Urban Stampede and you know, get that buzz, and then they move to a half marathon and full marathon. That's the pipeline.
Great concept. So you're going from 8 years on to upwards.
Exactly.
At all levels, you're trying to get them to get out and run.
Run.
More importantly, wear Puma and run.
That's right.
There you go. All right, we've run out of time on this very special broadcast. But Rajeev, Chitrangada and Girish, thanks a lot for joining in and sharing your thoughts. And let's hope, you know, like Usain Bolt, this also sets off well the Puma School of Speed.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.